Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to download and install IntelliJ Idea IDE, and also later I will be showing you how to set it up for Java and also run a Java program in that. So let's get started. So first thing, just go to Google and type download IntelliJ Idea. You'll be getting the first link as jetbrains.com. Just click that, and in this website first thing you'll be having the IntelliJ Idea Ultimate Edition, which is a paid one, and if you want to go with the free one, just scroll down, and here we'll be having the IntelliJ Idea Community Edition. This is for free, and you need to just click on download. So the download is getting started, and it is about 664 MB in size, so just be patient. So once the download is complete, just open the file. Just click on yes, and you'll be getting the IntelliJ Idea community setup. Just click on next, and this is the default location where this is going to get installed, which is in local disk C and program files. If you want to change the path, you can change it. I'm fine with this. I will just click on next, and in this we need to check this IntelliJ Idea shortcut. This is good, and update the path variable. This is also fine. Open as project folder. This is fine. And I am going to use this for .java purpose. I'm not going to do Gradle or any other thing extra. So just click on this one. If you want, you can just check on Gradle or Groovy depending upon your use case. Just click on next, and this is fine. Just click on install. So once the installation is complete, you'll be getting an option to restart your system. So if you want to restart it right now, you can just click on reboot and click on finish. I don't want to restart it now, so I'll just click on finish. So after it is installed, let me just go to search and type for IntelliJ. I'll be having this one over here. I'll just open it, and we need to click on do not import settings. Just click on OK, and we'll be getting the interface now. So now we are done with the installation of IntelliJ. Let's just go and download and install Java JDK. So just go to Google and type Java JDK download, and you'll be getting the first link as Java downloads. Just click that. It is from oracle.com. And here we will be having Java 20 and Java 17, and Java 20 is the latest version of Java, the latest JDK version. So you can just go here, scroll down, you'll be having it for different operating systems. We are going to download it for Windows. Just click on Windows, and here you will be having MSI installer. So just click on that. So it is about 158 MB in size, so just be patient till that. So once the download is complete, just click on open. You need to click on next, and you can just change the location if you want to. The default is fine for me, so I'll just click on next. So the installation will begin. That's it. So once the installation is complete, you will be getting this successfully installed message. Just click on close. So now we need to add our Java path to the environment variables. All right. So just go to the folder where you have installed Java. So by default, it's going to be C, program files, Java, JDK 20, and you'll be having this bin thing. So you need to copy the till bin folder. Just control C, just go to search and type environment. You'll be getting the edit the system environment variables option. Just click on open, and in this, you'll be having here environment variables. Click that, and under system variables, just click on path, edit. You need to click on new, and you need to just paste this. All right, you need to have till bin folder, and just click on OK everywhere. Now just open your command prompt. Just zoom it. So we need to run the command java hyphen hyphen version and hit enter. So here you can see that I'm getting Java 20, which is the latest version of Java that we have installed right now. So you'll be getting this message if you have done the installation process in a perfect way. So in case if you aren't getting this, you must have made a mistake in the path. So just try checking that path. So now we are done installing Java. Let's again go and open IntelliJ Idea. And now let's see how to set it up and run a Java program. All right. So just click on new project. And it has automatically detected Java JDK present in our system. So that's the cool thing about IntelliJ. It automatically detects the things. And here we are having some options. First thing is the name. So I'll just give it as first Java. And second is the location where your Java program is going to get stored. So I'll just click on this and I'll just click on OK. So this is going to be the location D and the first Java program. And this is fine, generate code with onboarding, yeah, add sample one. And the language that we're going to use here is Java, select that. And this is just the same, you have the module name, module file location. This is, everything is fine now. We can just click on create. So here you can see I am getting a basic Java template now available for me. And this is my program, the project over here. And inside the project, I'm having the source, and this is my main.java file. So these are the things automatically created, okay? So for running this, we can just click on this run button. So I think this program is going to print the numbers. Yeah, so here you can see, it's just printing the numbers. And if you want to change this one, I can just, you know, remove this. I can just have a hello, yeah? And if I run it now, I'll be getting only a hello. So this is how you do it, guys. I hope you would have found this video useful. Do check the playlist of my channel. I've done a lot of tutorials in Java, C, C++, Python, Node.js, React.js, MongoDB, MySQL, Spring Boot, CRUD operations. Check them out. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.